Welcome to Clouds.Training. This is Divakar and this is part 1 of Learn Application Development using .NET Core. In this lesson, we will learn about the history of .NET Core and how it is evolved. Nowadays, the term internet is so popular that it is running across billions of devices around the world. So when you think of internet, what do you do in the internet? For example, you may take a computer or a laptop and type a website address. Let's say bing.com, google.com or facebook.com. And when you hit enter and when you are connected to internet, the request is sent across the internet. Let's pretend that this globe is the internet and it is somehow processed and it understood what you requested for. And it will send the content back to the browser in your local desktop or a laptop. So what is happening behind the scenes? Essentially, this bing.com or google.com or facebook.com is called a website. So in software terms, a web application development is so popular. And there are other terms like mobile applications development, Windows application development, etc. And among these, web application development is so popular. In the early stages of web application development, they have only static web pages with some HTML and CSS. These static web pages are hosted in the servers and served across the internet to the end user. In this example, we have a web server where this static page is hosted and upon the request it is served to the end user. After the static page era, we have client-side dynamic pages using JavaScript. After JavaScript era, we have server-side rendering using ASP, JSP, also PHP. So this has become really popular and many applications were developed. Data was able to persist in the backend systems like databases. So this has become really popular and many applications were developed using these technologies. Even though the server-side rendering was extremely popular, it was really difficult to implement the systems because they were tightly integrated and enhancing the existing systems or modifying the existing features was really tough. So the rapid application development model has evolved and the classic example for this is Microsoft .NET Framework web application development. And then we have a modern web application development using MVC. This is what we are going to use in our .NET Core application development. So when we take an example of .NET framework, it can only be deployed to Windows servers. That is the limitation of .NET framework. You need to have a Windows server only to deploy your .NET framework based applications. So that's where the beauty of .NET Core comes into picture. .NET Core is cross-platform. You can deploy .NET Core applications in any server like Windows, Linux-based or Unix systems. So you can deploy pretty much in any operating system these .NET Core applications because they are cross-platform and they don't depend on Windows servers anymore. In the next lesson, we will understand the basic concepts of MVC. Before we decipher MVC, model, view, and controller, we will understand the concept of MVC. Thank you for watching. If you have time, please join me in the next lesson.